Is the screen visible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
अच्छा जी, बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। सो वी आर स्टार्टिंग द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर एंड दैट इज रिलेटिंग टू द थर्ड फंक्शन ऑफ मैनेजमेंट, दैट इज द कंट्रोलिंग। ठीक है, सो So in the chapter we will be discussing what is controlling, what are its salient features, similarly the control process, the process of control in the organization, and then certain other aspects of controlling such as strategic control mechanism and other such things. So as we discussed that in the management, we are having four basic functions. ठीक है, that is the planning. We discussed that in the planning process, we select the objectives and goals, and then the way how to achieve those goals. And in the organizing function, we divide the task into jobs and departments in order to efficiently and effectively achieve those goals and objectives. Now the third function, important function, that is actually the controlling function of management. Okay? And it is sometimes stated that controlling and planning, they are actually the two sides of a coin. That is, they exist in combination with each other. There is no planning without control process, and there is no control without planning process. Okay? So now what is control or controlling function? Okay? So controlling can be defined as a process of monitoring performance and taking action to ensure desired results. And it sees to it that the right things happen in the right ways and at the right time. What does it mean is that when we are planning, so we are choosing certain goals to achieve and certain objectives to achieve, and we also delineate how these goals and objectives that will be achieved. Now, for that purpose, we are organizing, okay? And in the organizing, we are hiring the employees that will be performing particular tasks in order to achieve those objectives. Now, while performing those objectives or those tasks, employees that must be, and similarly the processes that must be controlled and monitored such that we are getting the desired results. So it means that the controlling process that ensure that the things happen as it is required, okay, without wastage of any resources. Okay, so a process of monitoring performance, that is, it monitor the performance, okay, performance of the organization overall, similarly performance of the departments and performance of the individual employee, and taking action to ensure desired results. Okay, so we will be discussing in the controlling process that the actual activity that is measured against the planned activity. Okay, and as a result, we are getting, it is very annoying that when the people come lately in the class. So take a now controlling process, if done well, it ensures that the overall directions of individuals and groups are consistent with short and long range plans. So that is very much important, that employees that are working in such manner, and similarly the departments overall, that they are getting to the overall strategic objective of the organization. As we discussed in the planning process, that although there is departmentalization in each individual, that is, in department that is pursuing its own goals and objectives. But actually, they are moving towards the same one direction of getting the overall objective of the organization. So it helps ensure that the objectives and accomplishments are consistent with one another throughout an organization. For example, if in the industry there is a production department and there is quality control department, and they are working in different lines, but the ultimate objective is to get a quality product. So the although the production that is concerned with the increasing the production, and for example, if the production is of not quality, then quality control that will be not approving those production items. Now, apparently, these are two contradictory approaches. Okay, because the quality control is apparently hindering the more production, but actually, that is not the case. But rather, both are achieving the same goal to produce a quality product. So it helps maintain compliance with essential organizational rules and policies. So through controlling process, we are ensuring that there is compliance to the rules and regulations of the organization. So without controlling process, we cannot know whether an employee or in a department or a part of the department that is complying to the rules and regulation or not. So as you see that there is a strong linkage between the controlling and planning process. As I told you earlier, that these are actually two sides of a coin. So there is no controlling without planning, and there is no planning without an efficient control mechanism. If you see that we are planning, okay, and then controlling, organizing, controlling, leading, controlling, and the controlling process by itself. So planning and controlling that are going side by side, and actually they are part of the overall planning process. So actually controlling is also one of the process of the planning, because it gives you necessary data and reasons, okay, or evidence for corrective measures. Okay. Now there are certain roles of controlling. Okay. That is, what are the different roles that a controlling process is playing in the overall management? Okay. So efficient controlling, that is very much important. Okay. So the first benefit or advantage of controlling process is that it enables authority decentralization. Okay. That is a very much needed function of the organization, as we discussed in the organizing function. So decentralization, there is always desirable if it is or if it can happen. And the controlling process that makes the organization to decentralize. That is, when there are efficient controlling mechanism existing, so then the authority that can be decentralized and distributed into the organization, lower setup. So that is a very much advantage of the controlling process. The second benefit or advantage of the controlling process is that it is certain performance. What does it mean is that employees are performing, similarly the departments that are performing their jobs, and how they are measured. Okay? So in the controlling process, actually, there is a measurement of the performance of not only employees, but the department and all other aspects, as I told you earlier. So it is certain performance. Without controlling mechanism, you cannot know that at what level the organization, its components, and the employees that are performing at which level. So it is certain performance. The third advantage or role of the controlling process, that it enhances coordination. It means that coordination that must be existing both horizontally and vertically in the organization in order to achieve the same goal of the organization. Now, the controlling mechanism that enables coordination, because it measures the performance of each department and employee as per the laid down rules and regulations in the planning process. So it enhances coordination mechanism. The fourth function or the role of controlling is that it detects irregularities. Okay? So that is very much important in the organization. Organization usually that are large enough and having enough number of departments or employees that irregularities that cannot be easily seen. And it is only through control mechanisms that the irregularities that can be detected and identified. And once the irregularities are identified or detected, so it can be rectified in the subsequent planning process. Okay? The fifth is cope with uncertainties. Okay? So through control mechanisms, different types of risks that are involved in different organization functions that can be identified, okay, and that can be corrected, or the corrective measures that can be taken. And the sixth advantage of controlling process is that it identify opportunities. Okay, so when you are consistently analyzing your organization, its strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, so you are coming across different opportunities, different types of improvements that may be done, and as a result, different opportunities that are identified. So it is only possible through control mechanism. So these are different roles of control. Now control, that is...
Point, I'll repeat, sorry, sir, number five.
Yes. Yes.
Sir, fifth point.
Fifth point, cope uncertainties means that if there is any risks, okay, or any uncertainties that are involved in certain processes. Okay? For example, there is a failure of a product. Okay? For example, a product that is not successful in a market. Okay? Or there is no demand, for example, or there are more efficient competitors in the market. Okay? So through control mechanisms, for example, if their production or their sale that is reduced, so that can be identified. Okay? So with this, you can identify the weaknesses in the organization. Now, what can be the qualities of an effective control mechanism? Okay? So the control word that is often annoying. Okay? As you see that human beings that are willing to freedom, okay, and they are not willing to subjugate or to be controlled. Okay? So control mechanisms doesn't mean that you are annoying the employees or the departments, okay, or the sections, whatever. Rather, it should be effective and efficient. Okay? And that is why the control mechanisms that must be designed carefully. Because if the control doesn't mean that you become bossy or you just administer your authority just to satisfy your ego. So it is not like the case. Control mechanisms are actually aimed at improving the performance of the employees as well as the organization. So therefore, control processes that must be tailored effectively to the organization and its different goals and objectives. Now, these are different okay, so if see to these different purposes, okay, so there should be the qualities that must be present in the control system. Okay? So the first of that is strategic placement. Strategic placement means that control mechanisms should be aimed at एक्चुअली सिक्योरिंग और एक्वायरिंग द स्ट्रेटेजिक गोल्स एंड ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. ठीक है, नाउ इफ द कंट्रोल मैकेनिज्म इज नॉट एम्ड एट गेटिंग द performance of the organization efficiently and effectively, then there is no need of the control process and it will only be annoying and dissatisfying the employees. And hope you are getting these points. Similarly, it should be corrective action. Corrective action means that once you are performing the control process, so definitely deficiencies that are identified, as we will discuss in the control process. Now, if those identified deficiencies that are not rectified in the next phase of planning process, then there is no need of control processes. Okay? So the control process that must be correcting the deficiencies or improving the deficiencies. Another aspect is the accuracy of the control process. Accuracy is, you know, that you are getting the correct results persistently. So if correct control processes are not accurate, it means that they are not getting the required objectives of the control system, then it is useless and only a wastage of the resources. Similarly, timeliness is another important phenomena of the control mechanisms. If they are not timely identifying the problems and improving its solution, so then there is no need of the control process. Similarly, economy, there is another important aspect of control mechanisms. Control mechanisms are always costly, and then over and above expenditures on the organizational processes. So it must be economical, and the control mechanism that must be obtained economically. Flexibility is another phenomena. A control mechanism that must be flexible means that it should provide solutions keeping in view the individual requirements and also the goals and objectives of the organization. Another aspect is the understandability of the organization. So can anyone tell me what is the understandability of the control process? Yes, anyone? Can you hear me? Yes. Anyone? G. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
आवाज सब आ रही है ना?
बिल्कुल ठीक है सर जी.
Okay. So what is understandability?
Sir, जी the quality of a comprehensible language, sir.
Understandability means the control mechanism that must be understandable. Okay? It means that, as I told you, that control mechanisms are always annoying and difficult, are not likely for the employees. Okay? So it must be understandable. It means that you are employing a control mechanism. For example, you are employing a principle that no student will be allowed to the online class after the class is started. Now this is a rule, this is a control mechanism to ensure that the students must get in time into the class. Now this is an understandable phenomena. So anyone, for example, if that is left out, are not allowed to the class, so next time he or she will be trying to come to the class on time. So that is an understandable, that is a control mechanism that is understandable. Okay? Reasonable criteria. Okay? So reasonability means that the criteria to evaluate the employee or the department, that must be reasonable. Reasonable means that there must be a room for human errors and many other aspects of motivation. Okay? So it must be reasonable. Similarly, emphasis and exceptions. Okay? So most of the time, organizations that run as per routine, and only there are certain processes in which there is more likely the deviation that may be existing. So that is actually the organization control that actually emphasizes on the exceptions. Means that they timely identify the deviations from the normal course of एक्शन, ठीक है. सिमिलरली देयर मस्ट बी मल्टीपल क्राइटेरिया इवेल्युएशन, ठीक है. सो देयर फॉर एग्जांपल इफ यू आर इवेल्युएटिंग एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन और डिपार्टमेंट और एन एम्प्लॉय और ए प्रोसेस, सो देयर मस्ट बी मल्टीपल क्राइटेरिया. सो फॉर एग्जांपल इफ ए इंडिविजुअल और ए पर्सन और ए डिपार्टमेंट दैट इज नॉट कंप्लाइंग विद वन क्राइटेरिया, सो इट डजंट मीन दैट दैट इंडिविजुअल और द डिपार्टमेंट इज efficient or deficient. So there must be a multiple criteria that should evaluate the performance, okay? So these are different aspects of the control mechanism, okay? So control mechanism that must be tailored to the organization requirements, otherwise it will lead to dissatisfaction and lack of motivation and annoying of the employee, and will actually lead to decreasing the overall performance of the organization rather than improving the performance. Okay, so that is sufficient for today. Okay, we are not in any hurry. Okay, so that is sufficient for today. If you are having any question, so you may ask the question. Ji. Yes, any question? Recording, inshallah, I will provide if it is sent. Thank you, Ji. Many regular students I don't see in the online classes. So that is not a good sign for the online classes. عمدہ قیو دے رسارہ کا سلمان کہ ویچ در اولی کا مدرلہ ٹھیک شو جی.